This Misty Minute is about covering your shoes to match an evening gown. My last evening gown I had made out of this type of fabric, or at least pieces of it, right? In this real pretty, stoned, gorgeous fabric. And my favorite shoes right now are these. Real skinny, strappy shoes. So, how can you cover this part of the fabric, this part of the shoe, in this type of fabric? It just wouldn't be done very well. So, what I did, and had my brother help me with, is stone another pair of shoes, the same shoes, like this. So, this Misty Minute is basically how I did it to share with you. First, I took a spray paint very close to the lining of the dress and spray painted the whole shoes. And then I went to like a Pearls or Michaels or Joann's Fabrics and got a bunch of little stones or beads rather, because this fabric is mostly beaded. And I actually took some of this fabric and pulled off some of the stones and put them in there. But I created this concoction of several different kinds of beads and stones to make it multicolored like the dress. And then what you do is you take E6000, which is amazing. I use this for almost all of my rhinestoning, and you coat, obviously it would be spray painted, but you would coat each layer in E6000 and then pour the beads on. And you could do one or two layers just depending on how thick you want it. And then what I did was, after all of it was stoned, I went through and put like a clear polish on it to make sure that they wouldn't bump off or fall off. And I even put rhinestones to match the shoe. And then of course I took the actual fabric and put it on the heel, so it matched perfectly there. But the funny part about evening gown competition, you didn't even get to see my shoes. But just in case I had to walk upstairs, they were gorgeous. And that was a Misty Minute. Every drag queen should pray for a boyfriend who's creative and or artsy-fartsy-ish. And I am so thankful that my little brother is so creative and excited to help me with functions like this, because it was a blessing to have him help me with my shoes. I oversee it every step of the way, saying, no, I like this, or do it this way. But he was so meticulous and perfectionist, whereas I would have slapped it on and done it in a hurry. He really took his time, and I'm so thankful for that. So hopefully you'll have somebody amazing help you with your shoes.